combat in Devil May Cry has always felt fucking incredible. That's like the whole draw of the series, but I cannot express how fun and fluid and responsive this combat feels. This looks like a terrible, terrible room. Full of... Are you kidding me with that shit? Are you kidding me with that shit? Fucking explosive barrels. Gotta try doing one of the charge moves with the Devil Breaker.
Bingo.
Let's see what that does. Yes, classic DMC platforming puzzles. So far, this game is every fucking thing I could have wanted and more. Enemy spawns down here. Or a secret mission, maybe. Nothing. Yeah, right fucking there. Don't let any red impusa escape. This is gonna be so annoying. But if I get it, that's my fourth blue orb, and I get alive, so might have to try this one a couple of times.
Thank you.
Did I do it? There could not have been a better arm on me for this job. Seriously, I'm not really sure why anybody would use anything but this rocket arm. It's like clearly the most useful. Just pin enemies down. Probably have to shoot that thing. Fucking targeted, man. It doesn't just keep going forever. Time. These things used to scare the fuck out of me when I was a kid. Where did she go? Am I not fighting this person? So is this where I'm supposed to go? And then this other thing over here is like a little secret. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Alright, so I'm supposed to be in there. So this is its own. So then what does this one do? Was it just like a... not really going any higher than the platform we've already been on, so... Yeah, I guess this is just a... really just climbing the stairs is like way easier than doing that. I don't get it. I feel like I'm missing something.
Follow. You? No way, asshole. You bring that shit to me.
I forgot how to fight those things. In DMC1, it was just shotgun to the face. You broke their mask off. And that was the end of that. Absolutely gonna knock over every bookshelf. For some reason, this is like oddly satisfying. Why is this so much fun? Yes, I need more punchline. Waiting for like a gold orb or something to drop from down from one of these, and then I'm gonna laugh in all of your faces for calling me crazy. God damn it. Totally want to get on these other ones in case they're like secret orb drops. Fuck you. guess not. Worth a shot. This music is so strange for a Devil May Cry game, but I'm digging it. What the fuck was that? Thing for you to say just then, Nero. This is a big fight room. Should have saved those till I actually needed them. I call Nico in here. Do they not have cell phones in this version of reality, though?
Howdy.
$30,000 orbs. What can we do with 30,000 orbs? Definitely upgrade this. God, it goes up to level 3, jeez. Let's buy another one of these while we're here. Even buy another one if I really wanted to. Do a little bit of this. This might be a good combo to learn. Also kind of want this, so. Let's save. Let's save up. Always better to have orbs when you need them than not have them, which seems obvious, but I'm always super conservative with currency, especially in Devil May Cry games, because in Devil May Cry 1 I fucked my... I played it when I was like a little kid, and I fucked myself over for a long time because I was not buying blue orbs or purple orbs, like, to upgrade your life and devil trigger gauges. I was not buying them at nearly a quick enough rate, so I got to, like, end game, and I was so underpowered, especially for being a little kid who didn't have any skills, and I didn't have any money to buy anything, and it fucked me for years. I tried to beat that game when I was, like, 13, 14, 15. I would go back every year and try. This looks like a boss room. No wonder why we can call her in right here. Maybe I should just buy that another blue orb and just...
Hiya.
Maybe not. We don't need it. We don't need it. I wonder if the progression of the bar carries over between characters. Like, is Dante gonna... and V gonna benefit from all the health upgrades that I've purchased? And right now there is no devil trigger gauge, so I don't think we have to... I'm sure there will be at some point, as usually how these things go.
Chit chat or monologue? Just getting right to the point, huh?
All right.
Something different about it.
What the fuck do these things do? Very confused right now. This is gonna be bad. This is gonna be very bad. The fuck is she doing up there? How do I get up there, though? The fuck was that? I wonder if I'm supposed to use those things to get up to her. Is that how this is supposed to be? Out of the way, out of the way. Is there no healing? How do you get health? Is that lady? Shit, it is Lady.
Dante's friend.
It's Lady.
You know her?
From my gunsmith days.
What?
I can't believe you do this to Kyrie. I'm gonna have to tell her, man. I'm joking. Hey, loosen up your jock strap. Don't do anything I wouldn't do.
Kyrie would kill me right now.
Nice, we're doing pretty fucking good so far. We're doing way better than I thought we would be doing. Three orb jackpot plus 3,000 orbs. What is that? I would like to know what that is so I can do it again. Nier and V split up to find separate paths to the Klipoth, the demonic tree. Nier encountered a deadly demon wielding light as a weapon. A deadly demon wielding light as a weapon. When he defeated it, turned out to contain Lady. Can she shed some light on the battle with the Demon King? And what is V's true motive? Are we gonna find out at any point where V even came from? Maybe right now.
So V, you think this kid can kill Urizen?
One can only hope. But for now, we have a more pressing engagement.
Player change. Switch player to V. Command three demons on the battlefield, controlling the flow of combat from a distance. Vitality and orbs. Oh, nice. Vitality does carry over. And orbs held carry over, but you must obtain skills for V. Nice. So those blue orbs are totally worth fucking buying.